Hey guys, welcome back. And in this session, we'll talk about the accept statement in COBOL. The accept statement is used to transfer data or system-related information into the program during execution. And this data is transferred with the help of an identifier. And remember, there is no editing or error checking of the incoming data. The accept statement is used heavily in applications which are designed to run on standalone PC. So when the accept statement is executed, the computer waits for the user to type an entry on the keyboard and press the enter key. And when the user presses the enter key, the entry is stored in a variable identified on the accept statement and the cursor moves to the next line on the screen. On an IBM mainframe, the accept statement gets its data from the SYSIN device. As a result, this device must be set to the terminal keyboard if you want your program to work interactively. Now let's talk about the syntax of accept statement. So the syntax is pretty simple and straightforward. You have accept keyword followed by an identifier. After that, you have from keyword followed by a couple of additional options. And these options are used to read low volume data from the operator console or some other hardware devices or from the operating system itself. And remember, if the from option is omitted, then the data is read into the identifier with the left justification from the operator console. However, if the from option is included, then the data is read either from the specific hardware or from the operating system. Now let's talk about a couple of examples so that you can understand how you can use accept statement in your COBOL program. In the following example, we have used accept statement. After that, you have identifier 2, which could be your variable where you want to store the date. And after that, we have included a from keyword, and then we have specified the date. And similarly, you can specify the format of the date that you want to get from the operating system. And similarly, there are other options as well, and you can use them as per your requirement. In our second example, we have actually get the today's date from the operating system or from the system, and we have used accept. We have specified our variable name, that is a temporary variable, that is ws-tdy-date, and we have specified from date. So when you execute this statement, you'll have today's date, which will be returned by the operating system, and this date will be stored in your variable, that is ws-tdy-date. And you can use it as per your requirement. So far, if you have any question, then do let me know. Otherwise, let's move on to our next lecture.